All right, you guys ready? Is it time to feed the puppies? I'm going to show you guys how to properly whelp newborn bulldog puppies today. These puppies are a week old now. Some of these puppies will be visual fluffy Frenchies. All of them are automatically carriers. Pretty positive this girl right here will be a visual fluffy. Five puppies here, four girls, one boy. Ready, Pecan? Nope, this is not your show, Rem. It's the Pecan Pie Show, Remy. It's the Pecan Pie Show. Remy!
Remy, what are you doing? Remy, stop.
I moved your puppies. Thank you for not full out attacking her, but that was not nice. So I had Remy in the whelping box with her puppies all day. And I just took out her puppies, put them in the incubator, and you see I got Pecan in there, and I'm about to do Pecan in there. But Remy just totally took offense and was about to attack Pecan because this is her space. This is her puppy's space, the way she sees it. But no, Mommy, I'm switching things up a little bit, Remy. My other whelping box, I just finished putting a second coat of paint on it, so I'll have it set up tomorrow. I pretty much got Remy just whelping her puppies freely now. I'm pretty much gonna be done with the incubator. I'm gonna let Remy just take over her puppies in the whelping box. She's a little over 2 weeks old, her puppies. And as you've all seen, Remy is a OG, triple OG MVP mom. But she is still claiming this whelping box as her own. So that's what you just saw, her trying to attack Pecan Pie there. But all right, let's go. Discharge for the first few weeks. Hell, sometimes they have it for about eight to ten weeks. When they're nursing, they'll get like a jello-y blood discharge. Sometimes you won't really get much. Sometimes you'll get a lot. It really depends on your doctor who does the C-section on how good they clean her out. If they leave a bunch of stuff, you're going to get a lot of gooey blood over the next couple weeks. It's not a big deal. You're going to want to clean your girl down. This is dragon's blood. It's about 10 to 20 drops of betadine and water. You want to keep your girl nice and clean. You don't want your nipples to get infected or for your girl to get mastitis. Mastitis can be very harmful. Come on, stop, relax, Pecan. Relax, Pecan Pie. You're gonna wanna make sure you rub and clean off all the excess so the puppies don't taste it and get deterred. Let's do your five side. Let's do this one. Let's do this one. Visual fluffy lilac female. Little Pecan Pie clone, we call her Hazelnut. chocolate sable, I think. I think this guy's a blue and tan. Another chocolate or black sable. All right, all the puppies are on. They're all latched. Whatever clinic you don't go to, they should give you a calcium supplement. So you should have a calcium supplement. Give your girls a couple drops every 3 to 4 hours until you're out. It's gonna help her keep lactating and producing milk. You can also buy a calcium supplement called Oracal, I think it's called. It's available on Amazon. It's good to give your mom that a couple days before her C-section and the first few days when she's struggling to make milk. You want to praise your dog and make her, let her know that this is what she's supposed to be doing. You want to make her feel comfortable. This is all I need you to do, Pecan, to stay nice and calm and let your puppies feed. Let your puppies nurse. Pecan Pie is a first-time mom. She's not into doing bowels too much. We're going to let these puppies nurse for about 10 to 20 minutes. Then we're going to do bowels. Puppies can't regulate bowels at this age. So the mom or you have to do it for them. You got to make sure they pee and poop. It's very important. I make sure my pups pee and poop after every feeding. I raise my pups in the incubator for the first 3 weeks. I feed my pups every 2 to 3 hours for the first 2 to 3 weeks. I go from incubator to nipple. Incubator to nipple and back into the incubator. I let the puppies nurse for 10 to 20 minutes. Then we'll stimulate bowels. We'll get all the pee and poop out of them. We'll get them back into the incubator. The incubator is the safest environment for the puppies. And it allows Pecan Pie to have a break from all these little puppies sucking on her titties. The incubator is a temperature and humidity controlled environment. I like to keep my incubator at 86 when puppies are born, and then I come down about 1 degree every week. I like to keep my humidity at 65. I keep an oxygen concentrator on hand unless I need it, in case I need to add oxygen. And also a nebulizer in case I need to add nebulizer treatments. Come on. Calm down, Brittany. Sometimes you gotta, some nipples aren't as easy and some dogs can't suck as good. So you see, I had to kind of prime it. I kind of had to help her get going. Remind her there is milk in this nipple, so don't give up. She hasn't been lactating as much as I'd like. I just started giving her some cottage cheese. Cottage cheese is a really good trick for getting your mom, your bitch to lactate. You give them cottage cheese and typically in 24 to 36 hours, there's gonna be milk coming out left and right. I don't know if you guys saw yesterday when I put Remy down, she had milk just coming out of her titties. It's because I put her on cottage cheese. A pretty fluffy little girl.
Oh, 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 it wasn't time for that yet.
Well, I guess it's time to do bows. Right under here, where the pups are, I have a heating pad. So there's a heating pad right here to keep the puppies warm. Puppies can't regulate temperature at this age either. Alright, now we're going to start stimulating bowels on this little female. Let's see if Pecan wants to do it. Come on, Pecan. But the puppy is making me handsome. See if Pecan wants really nothing to do with it. Use a moist baby wipe, the wetter the better. And you're just gonna rub the lower abdomen area. Just gonna gently tickle or rub the lower abdomen area. Just as if you were a mom dog licking her. See, she already kind of shit all over the place, so we'll see. But I'm pretty confident she's got more in her. Apparently that poop was all she had in her, it looks like. Let's move on to the little blue and tan boy. You're gonna be a blue fawn. I don't think he's going to be a blue and tan. I think he's going to be a blue fawn. He's going to lose all that color. He's going to go tan. He's going to go to a light tan, but he'll have like a darkish bluish face. I think he's going to be a blue fawn. Might be a blue and tan. Just want to give him a clean up. Kind of wipe him all over with a clean baby wipe first. Get him nice and clean. And now, whoa, 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 slippery puppies. Don't worry, these puppies can handle being dropped, thrown, all that stuff at this age. They're like rubber. They're used to being handled by a dog mom with teeth and no hands. You got some action off the rip. So the way I'm holding it is very important. You see I'm allowing these feet. You want to keep those feet locked in so they can push. So I'm not squeezing the dog right now. I'm just holding my hand in a rigid position so the dog's feet can push and it can make its own bowel movement. So I'm not squeezing the dog. I'm just allowing it to have a nice, firm area to push. Really clean. I like to go over the puppy first with a clean baby wipe. Get any pee, poop, residue, anything, any of that nasty film. I like my puppies clean. Give them a quick once over. Get the legs. Get these legs. See, you got one out, and he's peeing on me. Gotta get that leg in there. And there we go. Collars just for identification purposes. These two females are very close, very similar. It's very important that you do daily weight logins with your puppies. I don't weigh my puppies until the day after I come home for the C-section. So the next morning I weigh my puppies and then I weigh them every day after that for at least the first 2 weeks. The first day or two, it's okay to see a weight loss because your puppies are gonna come out bloated. So it's okay for them to lose a little weight day one and day two. But after that, your puppies need to be gaining weight every day. If you have a puppy that is not gaining weight, you need to address the problem immediately. Puppies will fade quick. If you have a puppy that is not gaining weight, you have an issue that needs addressed immediately.
or your puppy will die. If your puppy stops nursing, you have a very big problem that you need to figure out immediately, or your puppy will probably be dead in 24 to 36 hours. One of the number one killers of puppies, I think it is the number one killer of baby puppies, is aspiration pneumonia. Aspiration pneumonia is when a dog aspirates. When a dog aspirates, it's when the milk and the fluid comes back up through the lung, through the nose. When a dog aspirates like that, fluid can get into the lungs. When the fluid gets in the lungs, now you have aspiration pneumonia. Aspiration pneumonia kills puppies fast and quick. This is a nasal aspirator machine. If any of my puppies aspirate, I use this machine, I clear out the nasal ways, clear out the passageways, dry it all out immediately. If for some reason I think it was too late or it was too bad and my puppy has fully aspirated, I'll listen to it. If I can hear fluid in the lungs, I think my puppy's aspirated. It's not feeding, it's acting different. It probably did get fluid in the lungs. Now you need to get your puppy on antibiotics immediately. I keep Clavamox on hand. I keep an antibiotic called Clavamox on hand. How? I can't tell you. Figure it out. It's part of being a dog breeder. You need to have all your own medications, all your own drugs, medicines at your own disposal. There's not time for you to go to a vet, convince your vet what you need, and get them to give you a prescription, get the medicine, and give it to your pups in time. Not to mention, they're normally not going to give you what you want. So you need to source out all your own antibiotics and medicines on your own. And you need to have your own mini fucking pharmacy in your house ready for these puppies if you want to keep them alive. You need to learn how to identify things on your own. This is probably breeding dogs is probably one of the things that's looked at as such a simple thing by so many people incorrectly. It's very complex. There's a lot to it. This is a 24/7 job. It's not just one job. I'm about 15 fucking different jobs in one. You gotta be a photographer, a marketer, a veterinarian, a caretaker, a fucking everything. Janitor? I feel like y'all's janitor. Oh, we got poop coming in. And if you see, this puppy looks like she looks like she's got a little bit of diarrhea, which is not a big deal with puppies. Fairly common, especially when they're young like this. But it still can get addressed. I'll show you in just a second what I do for diarrhea. Let's make sure we got all the pee and poo out of this pup. This is the fifth and final pup. Remy, take a breath, mama. Calm down. Your puppies are in the incubator, and then I'll give you this whelping box all to yourself again, okay, mommy? Oh, yeah. So for diarrhea, I use Propectin. You can also get this on Amazon. Thank you.
puppies have all nursed. Oh, you're so pretty, little mommy. Puppies have nursed. We did the bows. We gave the one medicine that needed medicine. Look at this little fluffy baby. Look at my little fluffy princess. Rawr. Rawr. I'm a princess. I'm a little fluffy princess, you bitches. That's what she said. You did amazing, pecan pie. You did amazing. Even though you didn't help with bows at all. Even after your feedings, you should clean your bitch. Again, with the dragon's blood. If you don't know what dragon's blood is, go to my page. Go to educational content playlist. Watch the video on dragon's blood. While you're there, leave a comment. Share the video. I'm almost at 100K on this profile, everybody. I'd appreciate it if you guys could help me get there. I'm only a few K away from 100K. If everybody could go share some of my posts. Go share some of my posts. Go watch them. Let them loop. Run them over. Let them run over and over. Help run up the views. Tell your friend. Help me hit 100K. When I hit 100K, I'm going to do a special private puppy contest just for my followers. The same way Mike goes live and he clicks private for just his followers, I'm gonna do a live for just my followers at a very, very discounted price for one of my pups. It might be this Merle boy that I still have. I don't know. Or maybe one of Remy's chocolate and tan pups. Help me hit 100K. I'm gonna do a super small contest that gives everybody a really good opportunity to win one. All right, let's get these puppies back into the incubator. I will be doing a public contest for everybody also, I think, for one of the pups. But hit that follow button now. When I hit 100K, I'm gonna do a contest with a very low buy-in. So that everybody has a chance to get one of these pups. Look at Magilla Gorilla. Look at my boy Magilla, look at that big old belly. Should we get it, y'all? Oh, look at that belly. Oh, look at that belly. Oh, give me that belly. Give me that belly. Give me that belly. Don't you dare try to turn over. Give me that belly. Give me that belly. Links in the bio, Big Bone Bulldogs on all platforms. Go add my Instagram and you can DM me directly over there. You can send me a Gmail, Big Bone Bulldogs Gmail, or you can go to my website, bigbonebulldogs.com, if you're interested in a puppy. I don't talk about pricing on here. My link tree is in my bio. That will take you to me. It's not hard to get a hold of me. It's not hard to get a hold of me. fear is obsolete. That's interesting because I seem to put you in fear, buddy. The fact that you're saying I'm just getting likes tells me that you must fear me. So, I don't... Change your screen name, buddy. I am very exhausted. Should we get Remy's puppies back out? Let's put... Remy's been going crazy. Let's get Remy going. She is full of milk. I might have you feed pecans pups next. What am I doing? I'm grabbing the wrong pups. All these puppies had a bath time today. They got their 2-week bath. I don't like to wash my puppies for the first 2 weeks. I don't wash them. I don't wash the mom or the puppies until they hit 2 weeks. Oh, someone got shit on me. Oh, and your pit. Oh my God, little girl. This little girl came out shitting and pissing everywhere. Pups and within an hour, fucking shooting shit everywhere. Haven't had that happen in months. Beautiful chocolate and tan maskless boy is available. No, Terry. How about I won't? It's not for fucking cross-contamination. It's just for cleanliness. Congratulations. I don't care how you feel, Taylor. I don't like how your hair... I don't like that spray tan you have. Jesus Christ, lay off on the spray tan, Taylor. These are puppies. These aren't little liberal humans. These are puppies. These are dogs. Do you know how dogs play? They play rough. Do you know how puppies get treated from their mom dog? Rough. Do you know what makes a puppy comfortable? Being treated rough, okay? So, I'm the professional. I'll stick to doing what I'm doing. Humble yourself, pay attention, learn something. I have a bulldog farm from there, Ruby. Hit that follow button, you can watch the progress. I just moved out to my new bulldog farm. I bought this property just for my dogs. 1.5 acres of free land just for my bulldogs. I'm also building them a state-of-the-art $100,000 doghouse. State-of-the-art indoor kennel. Hit that follow button. You can watch all the progress. Go subscribe to my YouTube, The Bulldog Breeder. The Bulldog Breeder on YouTube. Click the link in my bio. Watch me build my bulldog farm in a $100,000 doghouse. World's first smart kennel. World's first bulldog farm. Let's hit 100K, everybody. I'm almost at 100K. I'm trying to hit 100K on this profile. I'm going to give away a puppy. I'm going to do a puppy contest when I hit 100K, everybody. Just for my followers. My followers only. Going to do a puppy contest. We're at like 97K. We're at like 97K. Hamburger Mary went viral the other night. Almost caught a heat stroke, but I saved her. My baby hamburger, she humped herself to heat stroke. She literally was humping Birkin so much, she gave herself a heat stroke within under 10 minutes. But we saved her and she's doing great, everybody. Go watch the video, it's tagged at the top of my page. Hamburger Mary went viral the other day for humping too much. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate all the love, everybody. Look at these little chocolate babies. Little lilac and tan female. One lilac and tan female, two cocoa chocolate females, and four cocoa tan males. Second heat. I know, right? People are hating too, trying to say I did it on purpose to like make the video and all this crazy shit. Like, I would never. Who would even think that? You gotta be a shitty person to even accuse me of that. I would never do that to my hamburger. And the shit lasted almost 45 minutes. So yes, I did have time to set up my camera. If you call leaning my camera on the stove, setting it up. And I had hundreds of people thank me for the video. Yet I had other people trying to make me feel bad for setting up my camera and making a video out of it. You're doing great, Remy. This is Remy's third and final litter. Remy will be retired after this litter. She's given me 6, 4, and now 7. 17 puppies total, and she has 17 grand puppies. I did, Debbie. I'm pretty sure this lilac female is a visual fluffy. She might be the only one, and you know what? I'm okay with that if she is. If I got a lilac and tan visual female fluffy, I'm happy. The rest can be carriers. But we'll see in the next few days. I think the blue tan or the blue fawn boy might be a fluffy. I really want Hazelnut, the little pecan pie twin, to be a fluffy. Oh, what was that? Disco ball. We got a disco ball, Cecilia. Cecilia with the disco ball. That means we got to dance for the disco. We got to dance for the disco ball. We're dancing for the disco ball. We're dancing for the disco ball. Boom, 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 boom. Disco, 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 disco. Disco, 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 disco. Disco, disco, disco. Disco, disco, disco. Tap that tummy, everybody. Tap that tummy, everybody. Tap that tummy. Tap, tap, tap that tummy. Notice Remy's you notice the difference of how Remy, how she's much more involved, how she's doing bowels. She's cleaning her pups. Remy is a OG. There's no better mother I've ever had than Remy. Remy is gonna absolutely hate me retiring her. She loves being a mother. She loves every bit of motherhood, if you can't tell. Did you not hear her whining the whole time I was on live with Pecan? That's because Remy wanted her puppies. Remy is an amazing mother. She's absolutely gonna hate being retired. Why would I toss the puppy like that? G-G-O-G-G. You said it yourself, G-G. It's a puppy, G-G. It's not a little liberal human. It's not a soft little emotional liberal human. It's a puppy. It's a puppy, honey. You should watch the way mother dogs handle their puppies. Very roughly. So you know what I do? I handle them very roughly also, so they feel comfortable. Thank you, everybody. Nah, no runts. I go for real good, consistent litters. Oh, we got fireworks from Sandra. We got fireworks. Oh, we got some shitting going on, too. Get that, Remy. You want that?
I don't like the way you're being rough with your puppies.
I'm some fucking 14-year-old chick sitting on my couch. I've never touched a puppy. I've never even owned a dog. You obviously look like you know what you're doing and a professional, but I'm still gonna fucking type my fat little fingers to say, I don't like how you're doing with your puppy. Sounds pretty stupid, doesn't it? My puppies matter to me. Your emotions do not matter to me. You're doing great, Remy. Remy let her pups nurse. Now she's gonna clean them. She's gonna stimulate bowels. She's gonna knock them around. She's gonna step on them. She's gonna be rough. She's gonna bite them. Does anybody wanna tell Remy they don't like what she's doing? Where's that little girl at? Is Remy making you feel uncomfortable? Is she being too rough with her puppies? Nice, congratulations, True Bellas. Well, what did you breed a fluffy to a fluffy? Exactly. Of course I kissed their little heads.
Oh.
Hey, little baby girl. Oh, you're a little boy.
The dad is a fluffy, is your mom a fluffy carrier? If your mom isn't a fluffy carrier, you won't have any fluffies. All your puppies will be fluffy carriers. Because the dad is a visual fluffy, he will pass one copy of fluffy on to all your puppies. But if your female doesn't have any copies to pass on, you will not have any visuals. My girl Pecan Pie is a fluffy carrier. She carries one copy fluffy. So whichever puppies she passes her copy on, it will link up, it will make two copies, and it will be a visual. The fluffy gene is a recessive gene. It needs two copies to express itself. So even though Pecan Pie is a fluffy carrier, she still looks normal. You need two copies of fluffy to express it. What if you have a female? I mean, make sure your female is breeding quality. Make sure you have papers. I would wait a while because the market is swamped with puppies. I would get her DNA tested so you know what color she can produce. That way you can match her up with the proper stud. You need to get her health tested to make sure she's clear of all genetic disorders. Appreciate that, James. She's fine. I'm trying to keep the weight on Remy. Remy normally loses a lot of weight, but I feel like I'm doing pretty good with her. She's maintaining her weight decent this time. She normally blows her coat too. Her hair is actually staying real nice too. She normally loses all her weight and blows her coat.
Well, it's good to have my account back. I caught a banana on the backup last night, so I got this one back just in time. If you're interested in pups, Big Bone Bulldogs on all my platforms, go to my Instagram and DM me, or go to my website. Remy, hush. Do not be nice to him. What's up, Jessica? All right, everybody. I think I'm going to get up out of here. I appreciate everyone hanging out with me. So does Magilla Gorilla. This beautiful boy is still available. Lilac and tan, maskless, merle, quad carrier, male. Available. 15 weeks. Available.